35th episode, we going steady. Only been a few days since the last, but I'm ready. Topics of nonsense of what I've been thinking. Welcome to my podcast, it's your boy still spinning. Intro so good, it could be a hit. Dental intern, I don't get paid to spit. Loving what I'm doing, in the end it's priceless. But maybe one day I'll get some advertisements.
Is that Beyonce?
No doubt it's Beyonce. Partition instrumental for those that are curious. I don't know if I can use it, but I guess we'll find out. Benefits of being a small show. You know, you can do whatever you want. And if you get a couple of drinks against you, you know, so be it. Yeah, so I just wanted to hop on the mic today just for a little nonsense talk. Just because I had some lot of random thoughts. And I just love doing this, and it's so much fun. I got my little intro, so I just had to, like, get it out there. And, yeah, I said that in the intro about the nonsense. So it's kind of like Game of Thrones, you know? It's like they show that, like, overview of, like, what cities you're going to see in the episode you're about to watch. Although I never remember what I just saw, so I don't remember. I can never. I actually should do that one day. Look at those things and then go with a clipboard as I watch the episode and check it off. Technology, I could use my phone. Make those little check marks. Speaking of my phone, I'm writing a ton of notes these days, and I'm utilizing the little, what do you call those? Check boxes that you can make on your notes app where you can, like, highlight them, and so you can, like, check them off. And you use, like, the dashes just to stay organized. I'm trying to stay organized. I just make so many notes. It's like I branch off into 4 million things. I have so many notes on my phone. I have notes for this podcast, my YouTube channel, my life, like groceries and just errands I have to do, bills to pay, things like that. But it's really helpful. Syncs up with my Mac. That's one thing I really love about having all Apple products, is that it all syncs. So when I sit down on my computer, I can do all these things. Like, I have my podcast notes posted up here. And that's also why I wanted to jump on the mic. I realized last episode, the documenting part, I really enjoyed, and I really liked that aspect of it. It motivated myself. I don't know if I meant to do that, but whatever. And so I just want to keep producing as much as I can to kind of keep you up to date. And also, I think it makes for a good storyline to see how I'm progressing. And it's just, I like listening to podcasts like that. And I kind of just want to contribute, as I've said before, but at the same time, it's good to get it, help me figure out what I'm doing. But at the same time, I feel like it helps other people figure out what they're doing. And it's motivating to see somebody working towards giant goals as I am, because I want to do some crazy stuff. So I think that's also one I wanted to talk about too, is like, what the hell am I actually doing? So it started off with just my YouTube channel. I just thought I wanted to have the goal of dunking one day. So I started just filming my progress, just because I really believed I could dunk one day, just because I was already, like, touching the rim when I started. So I'm like, okay, I could at least throw down one dunk one day, the minimum, right? So I wanted to film just so I have proof of my where I started, you know, because I wanted to, like, look back. And it was just a good measurement as I progressed to, like, see if I'm making progress. So that's how my YouTube started. And then as my channel grew and things like that, I started documenting how I was feeling and my workouts and things like that, because people, I felt there was a missing element of that for people making dunk videos, because back in the day, it was just people, like, showing their dunks, and then a few months later, they posted another video, and they made a lot of progress, and there was no in-between. People were lost. How did you make that progress? Things like that. So that's how it started, and I figured a good way is to show the day in, day out of what I do and how I feel and everything that I would have wanted to see when I was watching dunk videos trying to learn how to dunk, because I was on YouTube as well asking a million people, like Jordan Kilgannon and Andy Nicholson, how they got their progress and things like that. So I figured it wasn't there, so I would just create it, just because I made such good progress. I felt the need to share my knowledge of how to make progress jumping. And then I revamped my love for making videos, because I've always done that since I was a kid. I've always made silly videos, made weird special effects videos. I have this hilarious one with my friends from back in the day, and they're just so great to look back on. They're hilarious, and they're also fun to – whenever I went on vacation, I love taking pictures and saving those memories and things like that, because it's just really fun to look back on, because you forget all the things you did. And I always loved making videos. Ever since I was really little, I just liked the aspect of, like, the – I would make like little fake magic shows with my friends where like you'd snap and like something would disappear because you just like cut the camera and the person would stay still. Really funny. And then like the thing would disappear. So anyway, I had a crazy ideas from the start, and I always loved making videos. And now with this new age stuff with the cameras that are accessible, I can make like super cinematic things, like professional quality videos. I just realized my light is really far away, so I might be dark. So for those watching the video podcast, shout out to the video podcast watchers, because actually, I don't even know. I think there's probably more video cast listeners that watchers than there are audio. I don't even know who watches or listens to these, by the way. I get way more views on my dunk videos, but this is what I like to do too. Anyway, back to the story. So kept making videos and then found all these videos about people vlogging and things like that. And I like vlogging just because it's like everybody's unique and there's people showing their day-to-day life, and I like the story behind it, how people are trying to grow and achieve things, and it's fun to watch them make progress and how they do things. And it's really cool to see kind of behind the scenes, because we're really lucky that we get to see that, and people are like sharing their ups and downs. And not that like it's motivating to fight through the downs or anything like that, but it's just super cool to see what actually goes on in their lives to help them achieve what they want to achieve, whatever it is. And I find that so cool. And I like to do that too, because I had success dunking so far, like some, where I was able to achieve the goal of actually dunking. So I know it's really helpful to show the journey, but I have like so many other things I want to do, this podcast being one of them. And it sounds weird just to want to grow the podcast, but I don't want to just grow it to have a big podcast. I want to grow it because I love the information that's being shared, and I kind of want to be a part of it. And also, I have a lot of good conversations with my friends, and they're all on different paths. And I figured sharing those kind of conversations, like either having them on or just kind of talking through them again, even if I'm just by myself, that they're really interesting. And to share that, I feel like everybody benefits from them. And then we just get motivated to do what we want to do. And also, just by making the connection between people who are doing things, and it's not that uncommon for people to want to do these things that are out of the ordinary. I also really like when people have ideas or ambitions that I totally didn't see coming. Like if I have a friend that's doing some kind of normal job, but then they really have a passion in something completely different. I find that super interesting, and I love to know how they, what part of it interests them. And it's fascinating to me because I have all these random interests and I'm trying to figure out myself what I want to do. And I have, so let's just get into what I really want to do. I don't know what I want to do. And that's why I like this podcast as well, because I think by making this podcast and following the things I'm interested in, it'll lead to some kind of life where I'm doing what I like to do. So I know I like creating things, and I know I like helping others find what they like to do, find their passion and things like that. So this podcast is one great way to do both of those things. I can create some content, like, it helps me, for example, like I have a place to put my raps now. I've been rapping for a long time now just for fun, and it's a great place to put my raps. That's like so much fun for me now to make little intros for this thing. So I love doing that. I love making high quality videos and a podcast, and something you can listen to at any time. You can make it on, like, you can listen to it while you're driving, or, you know, whatever you're doing right now. You could be not even like half listening, which I do to a lot of podcasts, while you're doing laundry or, I don't know, doing other things at work or something. And also the videos is good. We can like interact and have like our own little conversation. And I try to make it high quality. I think this one's 4K for the people watching, but don't count on it, because a lot of times my computer can't handle it, so I might have to downgrade it. But you get the point. I'm working towards it. Plus my computer, I need an upgrade bad, so I'm saving money. So I also want to show that type of progress too, because I have this laptop from 2011. It's killing it. I've upgraded it a little bit, got some more RAM for the nerds out there that know all about computer specs. But the point is, I really want a better computer so I can stream live, because I physically can't with any type of camera. I even bought like a cheap webcam just to get some kind of camera, and just trying to live stream, it was lagging like crazy. So I couldn't do audio and video at the same time. Two simple things, can't do. But that's just one of my goals I have, is to get a new computer, save up some money, and get that. So I think it'll be so cool if you guys stay tuned and follow along, and eventually I get that, and then you could see how the progress grows from like me just doing this in my friggin' little apartment against a wall to maybe eventually having like some kind of studio with real guests and talking about other people who made their own podcast or made their own type of business or something like that. And I don't even know if I want to make a business. I just like the creative part of it. And that's the other thing I love to discuss, is that whenever I have conversations with my friends, it's really interesting to see what their natural strengths are. And for me, I love the creative side. I know, I feel like everybody would love to just make the idea and have somebody else execute it, but I love executing it as well. And that's another reason I want to upgrade my computer, is because right now executing things like making this podcast and making videos is so time consuming, because I don't have the top of the line equipment. Things take time to render. I have to convert things before I can even make videos and things like that. It's not just like seamless. So if that would be a huge upgrade, if I can get a computer. And I think about, I want the new iPhone because I love taking photos and I can have a really good camera in my pocket at all times. But it's really unnecessary, because my camera that I'm using to film this right now is pretty small. If I want, I could carry it around. But I'm just saying, I'm just working between pros and cons of everything. And I feel like it's just making progress. And I love hearing stories about progress. And I know my boy Isaiah is just like obsessed with progress as well as I am. So, and I think it's kind of contagious, but also just super fascinating and interesting. And I love to be a part of that. And I've said that a million times already. But the reason I've said it a million times is because I still am figuring out why. But at the same time, I feel like by just making progress is a great way to get to where you want to be. Because if you just take little things you're interested in, try to figure out why, constantly question it, and go at what you like and try to put your, design your life around the little interests that you have, I think you'll make the best life you can for yourself. And it's fun. And I love helping others as well, because it's a lot of fun. And I just feel like it's a great way to help each other. And that's like, it feels more fulfilling when you see somebody else that didn't think they can do something and they did it. It's great. It sounds super cheesy, but I know that for me, when I watch other people that did it, just by them doing it, even if they weren't trying to inspire anybody else, just by them showing others, just by showing like their own progress, it made other people realize it's possible. That's literally how I started when I watched Andy's videos. Like, he was my height. He went from touching the rim to dunking, and that made me do it. So by me producing this podcast I don't want to say everything working against me, but all the limitations I have at the moment, I'm super fortunate for what I have already, but it's been a slow process, and I've done little by little by little, and I'm still working on it. And it would be so great just to be keep growing, just to show others that where it started. And I feel like I was able to document from the start. So it's really cool, because my dunk journey, I documented from the start, but I was not lazy, but I didn't realize how in detail I should have been documenting from the beginning, because that would have been super cool. So now this is kind of like starting from the very scratch, explaining everything I do. Explaining a little too much, but you get the point. Documenting is too insightful to not share, and that's what I like to do. Anyway, I guess that's my first rant. I didn't even mean to rant that long, but let's do some comic relief. You feel me? So I watched this documentary called An Honest Liar. It's where this guy that was a magician goes around. It was like, have my computer. I could pull it up. When I get the new computer, see, I said when. Positive attitude, saying when instead of if. When I get the new computer, I'll be able to stream everything you're seeing so much easier, produce these so much better, and you could see my computer screen, because right now I'm Googling the name of the... Wait, an hour... I wrote an hour liar. I was supposed to write an honest liar, but I was... trying to talk as I do it. It's a documentary, and I'm Googling it to figure out when the time period was. So it's called An Honest Liar. It's a 2014 biographical feature film. Blah, blah, blah. Documents the life of a former magician, escape artist, and skeptical educator, James Randi. The Amazing Randi. I think it's the name of something like that. Does it say when it was, though? Partner of 25 years. Synopsis. Anyway, 1973, somewhere around the 70s, I guess, but he was kind of showing people that, all these like magicians that were like doing these little tricks or pretending to be psychics, they were just all false, and he could do all these tricks, and he was exploiting them because he was doing it for a good reason, because all these other magicians and things like that were, taking people's money and just like putting on these shows, and it was all a fraud, and people believed it because they didn't have the internet and things like that. Anyway, the weird part that I was watching this documentary, and this guy was in a straitjacket, And I've seen that in real life when people like escape straitjacket, but I never like thought about it. It's always like never in my life that I see someone in a straitjacket like try to get out. Reminds me of The Office, by the way. And they're like, this is gonna be awesome when he escapes. It's just like, all right, he's gonna try to escape. He's probably gonna escape. I don't know how he does it, but it's not like visually appealing. You see him in this straitjacket, and he's just wiggling around. In this clip in the documentary, I don't even know if it was the Randy guy, but it was just like a classic magician, and he's just like hanging upside down by his feet. I don't know why that makes it that much harder. I guess you're just swinging, and the blood's rushing to your head. Obviously, it makes it harder, but it's not like there's a time limit how long you're gonna, like, you're hanging upside down, you're gonna get dropped. And he's just wiggling, wiggling, wiggling for like minutes and just wiggling. And then next thing you know, he's out. And it's just like, okay, you can't tell what he did. And it's amazing, I guess, but we have no clue what he did inside. You can't see his arms. You can't like see if he like contorted his shoulders. Not that that's like bad, but I'm saying like, it might be amazing to see how he moved his arm. Like, out of its socket, something like that, but nothing. You can't see anything in it. And I'm done with straitjackets. Enough with that gimmick. If I see another straitjacket, you better be like Michael Scott and roll around on the floor, and it better be like a comedy thing where you can't get out of it, because I'm done with straitjackets. They're old news, you know? And I thought that was really funny. The other nonsense thing I was thinking about was, I have a dog. His name's Garrison. You probably met him. You might hear him playing with his frisbee right now. It was his birthday, by the way. I think I said that in the last one. He's one. And he loves to fetch. Like, we play fetch, and he loves to bring me back the ball. And it's just weird because he just loves to do something so much that's like irrelevant. Like, it used to be for ducks, and I get that, and things like that. And other dogs, they just love to do jobs. And it's so strange to me because they don't like know that why they're doing it, really. I mean, I don't know the psyche of a dog, but you get the point. It's like they love these jobs. All they want to do is make you happy. All they get happy by doing these jobs, right? What if you could teach it to like help you more? Like, what if you can give it to give you a massage? Like, I woke up this morning and my back was like super tight. I think it was from like driving so much over the weekend, but for visiting the fam for the holidays. But like, what if he could give you a massage because he loves to do his job? And what if you taught his job to be a massage, and you just have these dogs that they love to do it, and you have like when you like see those massage chairs and you're like, these are great. It's like an unlimited massage. You don't need like a purse. You don't have to pay for it. You get this massage chair, and you get a massage anytime you want, as long as you want. That's, imagine you teach a dog to do that, and he gives you like a real deep massage. This dog's like 70 pounds. If he's standing on my back, it's pretty good, you know? So yeah, that's it. I'm teaching Garrison how to give me a massage. And that's that. If that happens, I'll let you know. But you get what I'm saying? It'd be hilarious if he loved to do it. Like, that was like what made him the happiest. Just like running and fetching and like sitting and being like obedient. Like, because he loves to like do what he's told. Like, he gets really happy when you like give him treats and you train him. He loves that. So if you taught him to give him a massage, and you said like, man, that was a good massage, and that makes him the happiest, I think it's a win-win. Anyway, he's going crazy with his frisbee if you hear him. Oh, another sign. This is all nonsense, by the way. Another sign. This is one thing I wrote down, is that if my feet are tan, it's a sign of success. Because I got a little bit of tan over the weekend, or sometimes I get tan when I just go out for, sometimes it's like a farmer's market outside and I'm walking around in Florida, or I'm walking the dog and I get a little tan, but it's always like my upper body or like maybe my legs if I'm wearing shorts. But if your feet are tan, you know that person's been outside, most likely at the pool or the beach, doing something in nature. And you can't get that unless you're outside or at the beach. So that's a really good sign that you're doing what you want to do. Because, that's what I want to do. I would love to be at the beach more or in the sun, because what I've been learning recently, not really that recently, but I've always felt that the sun feels so good. Like, when I get a nice sun bath and then go in the pool or the beach and then come out, my body feels the best. Even my mental state feels the best. I just feel in the best mood. And I always just felt that. I always felt it was just like the vitamin D, you know, you kind of get your blood pumping just because it burns you a little bit. And then you go in the water and you swim around, you get your body moving, blood pumping. But it's actually like there's like ions in the water or the ocean, and the vitamins from the sun. We all know vitamin D, but like the vitamins mixed with the ions, like, recharge you, but like ground you and things like that. And you're barefoot a lot of times when you're in the pool, so you're connecting with the earth. things like that. So I love that. So my goal is get my feet tan, because there's only one way to do that, and that's barefoot outside. That's it. That's all I got to say. Next thing. Got a text. Shout out Doug, if you listen to this. My boy Doug, I gave him my number recently, and he texted me, and he said, yo, it's Doug, and I don't have his number. So Apple suggests, it says maybe, like now it doesn't just say the number anymore. It says like, oh, maybe, and it suggests like who the person could be. I guess it like looks in her and says, maybe Doug. And I'm like, you definitely know it's Doug, because he says it's Doug. You definitely have technology to read my text, and you're acting like you don't know it's Doug. Good try, but I'm on to you. And also, even if he didn't say it's Doug, they're definitely tracking his number and his information and where it's coming from in a database. He's in the iPhone iMessage system. They know it's Doug. Doug, we know it's you. Apple, we know you know it's Doug. So stop trying to act like you're not reading all of our texts and have all our data. I've accepted it. It sucks, kind of, because like you want to have privacy if you want it. And people say like, I have nothing to hide and things like that. But it's still good to have if you want it, you know, just because like, you know, some people like to move in the shadows and things like that. But yeah, I'm just sick of Apple playing dumb with us. You know, they're playing dumb, like we don't know what they're up to, but come on, man. We know what that's. Speaking of Apple, I mean, I want the iPhone X so bad. iPhone X, iPhone 10, what do you call it? I don't know. 10. And I was thinking recently that, like, it might be smart to grab the 8. Because, first of all, I've never seen anybody with an 8. I've only seen people with the X or the 10. So the 8 might be, like, you might snag it. Like, someone might have got the 8 by mistake. And they're like, oh, shoot, I want the 10. I got to sell this 8. I could snag that 8 for, you know, super cheap. Either flip it or keep it. But the point is such little demand for that 8. I might snag it. I got the 6S right now. It's doing its job. And that's it. And I would love to snag an 8. Flip it and get a 10. And also, the new computer that I want to get, it's crazy how expensive they still are. Like, it's like $2,000 for a 2013. That's 5 years. At least close to five years. 5-year-old computer that's still like $2,000. But the reason I've hesitated to get it is because it's old, and it's outdated. So when new camera technologies come out and video equipment comes out, like 8K, because there's 4K now, when 8K comes out, it's not going to be able to handle that much. But if I can snag one of those for cheaper, like $1,500 instead of like $2,000, it'll hold me over till like the next year or so, and then I can make another investment in a computer. But it would help me so much on my day-to-day that I think it would be great. And let me see what else I have that I wanted to talk about, because that's pretty much it. That's all my nonsense rants. I just wanted to get that out of my brain into the microphone, into your ears for you. That's pretty much it. For the way I was going to grow this too, that I want to just be transparent, which I thought were really great, is that I'm going to start doing more like snippets of my podcast, because I've realized when I talk for like an hour, I don't know if you can hear him with his frisbee, when I talk for so long, it's kind of, I don't want it to be like, you don't know where the good parts are. Like, even if there are no good parts, you don't know what all the topics are. I could label it, but you don't know what I'm going to talk about when, and maybe you're interested in the piece of it. So I'm going to try to cut it up to make it not very, but easily accessible to the parts you want to hear. And I look forward to hearing feedback on those pieces, because I feel like it'll be more condensed and a lot easier to focus than just like a 5-minute piece than a friggin' hour long piece. And I think that's pretty cool. And overall, like I said, I just want to keep growing this, and I look forward to having my friends. And I was thinking of having this like part where me and my friends just kind of brainstorm what we think will be a great way to grow our own interests into what we like to do and into our like careers. Because right now I have like a regular 9-to-5, which I like. It's going really well, but it's not like universal. Like, if I help people do what I'm doing at my job right now, it's not going to help that many people. I want to like help people on like a global universal scale, but you get what I'm saying. So like, I feel like through this, motivating people to do whatever they want and having people chase their passions and things like that, I feel like it's so much more intriguing to me, and I just would love to create content for that, because I can create content at my job and talk to people about how to get that type of job and things like that. But I feel like it's such a narrow focus, and I like what I'm doing. It's been really good to me, but I really want to make the universal inspiration type career as my full-time, because that would be amazing, and I would love that. I think that's it for now. I'll keep this one a little short and sweet. Sweet as in comic relief. Relief as in bars on a tree. Tree as in branches, and we're branching off into bars now. I don't know what I'm saying. That's it. I'm going to hit the gym now. Probably record that. If you had any moment where you were like, this is decent, go ahead and rate that podcast on iTunes. By the way, I'm going to see if I can get this on Spotify for those Spotify users. I haven't even looked into that, but I heard people have their podcast on Spotify. This is on everything. iTunes, Google Play, SoundCloud, and Stitcher for Android. Android users need a better app, I think. But it's also on like Spreaker, the website that it's published on, and on YouTube, because you can always just listen to it on YouTube. You don't have to watch it. Oh no, my video stopped. I don't know why my video always stops. See, that's part of the problem, is that my video just kind of cuts out whenever it feels like it. So, anywho, the ones on SoundCloud and Google Play, though, I think they kind of just, or maybe Google Play is good, but I think SoundCloud like only takes my top five, and like since I already published more than five, it's gonna like, it's not updating. So I want my like most recent five, but it's putting like my oldest five. So anyway, thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed. Let me turn the video on for the ending real quick. So that's it. Video's back on. Technical difficulties as usual, but that will change as we progress. So thank you. New intros every episode, unless it's not new. So just enjoy the ones we have, but I'm looking forward to more intros, more podcasts, more videos, and that's it. Thank you. See ya.